Hello, good afternoon. This is Anna Isaac and I come to you live from the News Minutes newsroom here in Bengaluru. We have breaking news for you where the Supreme Court has now ordered that the NIA cannot probe the marriage of Hadiya, who is of course the Muslim convert from Kerala. The Supreme Court has said that Hadiya has the choice to decide for herself, given the fact that she is an adult. I'm joined by my colleague Megha Varia. Megha, you've been tracking this case for several months now. Just tell us what the Supreme Court has said and what this means for Hadiya and for her husband Shafin Jahan.
So Anna, this was the first hearing after November. The last hearing happened in November when Hadiya herself appeared in court and said that that was her first appearance in court after the case went to the Supreme Court in July. And Hadiya had clearly stated that she wants to go back with her husband, Shafin, and not with her parents. So after the court heard her statements that she's willing, she's not willing to go with her parents, the court had basically sent her back to her college in Salem and asked her to complete her studies. So this was the status till now. So this today's hearing was the first time the case was again taken up after the last hearing. And in this, it seems that the Supreme Court has given considerable weightage to what Hadiya had told them last time. So the court has said that she's an independent woman. She's a major. One, she's a major. Two, she's an independent woman who can, who is capable of taking her own decisions. So it does look like the bench has given considerable weightage to what Hadiya has told them. Now, in today's hearing, there have been a lot of developments. So the most important development here is that the SC has barred the NIA from continuing the probe into the marriage of Shafin and Hadiya. So if you remember, the SC, another bench of the SC had asked for, had ordered for an NIA probe last year in July. This was after the Kerala government and Hadiya's parents alleged that Shafin, this Muslim man, has connections with the Islamic terror outfit ISIS. So after this, it was after this that the whole case came under the NIA. So in today's hearing, the SC has basically barred the NIA from continuing the case, saying that marriage is the validity of the marriage is not what should come into the investigation purview. It is whether Shafin has any criminal records or anything. So marriage should be treated differently than from the criminal activity per se. Now, another development is that till now, Hadiya was not a party to the case. So, after Kapil Sibal's appeal, she has been made a party to the case and the SC has asked her to file her response before the next hearing that has been scheduled in the last week of February. Now, these are the key points. So, although Ashokan is Hadiya's father. Although Ashokan's father's advocate, Madhvi Divan, argued that the safety of Hadiya is under threat. The SC basically did not buy that argument. They said that no, she is a major and she is not no longer in illegal confinement, right? Because last time, the last hearing, the SC had sent her back to her college. So until then, for about 10 months, Hadiya was under the custody of her parents in their home in Vaikim. This was after the Kerala High Court annulled her wedding. Now I'll go back to my colleague Anna Isaac.
Well, Megha, just to clarify once again, now the Supreme Court has today said that the NIA cannot probe into the marriage of Hadiya, but they've said that they can look into the criminal activity that her husband Shafin has perhaps been involved in. Now, the NIA had, in fact, they had probed him, they had questioned him in December. Can you give us details as to, you know, between November last year when Hadiya appeared in court and until now, have Shafin and Hadiya spoken to each other? Had they met each other? Also, what happens to the probe? You know, because the Supreme Court has very clearly said that they cannot look into the marital status of this couple. So, can you just give us a little bit of background as to what has happened in the last few months?
So after the last hearing, Hadiya was sent back to her college in Salem, and although her parents had told the media that they will not allow Shafin to meet her. Shafin had in fact gone to the college himself and interacted with Hadiya. So she also spoke to the media saying they could interact. The college did not resist or refuse permission to Shafin to meet Hadiya. So they have indeed spoken after November, so in the last 2 months. Now, regarding the NIA probe per se, so the NIA has claimed that the NIA has submitted a number of reports to the Supreme Court in this case. And in all these reports, the NIA has claimed that they have sufficient proof sufficient evidence to prove that the wedding that happened between Hadiya and Shafin was indeed a sham, that it was not an arranged marriage like the duo has been claiming. In one of the reports that NIA filed, they have said that Shafin indeed has connections. He has clear links with a few people who are connected with ISIS. So December last year, after this particular hearing, the NIA again questioned Shafin on his links. Now, a couple of weeks ago, the NIA also questioned two accused who are currently in police custody. They are currently in prison. They were arrested last year from Kannur for illegal activities and for having links with ISIS. So the latest reports that NIA is expected to file is expected to carry their statements. So these two accused who are now presently in jail, they have reportedly said that they know Shafin Jahan, they have been interacting with him, and that their statement is what will prove Shafin's involvement in the illegal activity. So these are the points that NIA will argue. These are the weapons that they will use to prove that the marriage was indeed a sham and not an arranged marriage like they have been claiming.
Anthony Rubin asks, who are the judges that were sitting on this case? Can you tell us? Yes, it was led by the Chief Justice Dipak Misra,
and there was Chandrachud also.
Chandrachud, yes, as well was, yes, in. Yes. So it was a bench basically comprising of Dipak Misra, who is of course the Chief Justice of India, and Chandrachud. Now, Megha, if you can just tell us, I mean, you've been covering this case. There have been several similar cases in Kerala as well of interfaith marriages. So, what makes Hadiya's case so much more different and has really sort of captured the imagination of Kerala and of Indian public at large?
So although Hadiya's case has been termed as a love jihad, as a case of love jihad, it is very different from the definition per se. So this is not a clear case of love jihad where the marriage did not happen because they were in love. That was not the case here. So the case started off with Hadiya's conversion. So Hadiya was born as a Hindu woman. Her name is Akhila. So she was a resident of Kottayam in Vaikkim. And she was a student in Salem College when she was reportedly, in her own statement, she was influenced by her Muslim friends. And then she chose to convert to Islam. So Hadiya's father, Ashok, and the family came to know about it. And then Hadiya's father moved to the Kerala High Court with a habeas corpus petition. In the first habeas corpus petition, the High Court has basically said that she is an adult woman. She has all the right to choose her religion of her choice, and they had disposed of the petition. But then a few months, and then that time Hadiya was sent with a guardian, a Sainaba. She's a social worker from Malappuram and associated with this center, Satya Sarani. After a few months in August 2017, Ashokan again goes back to court saying that, against Hadiya's conversion, and says that she's in the custody of this Sainaba, and that's not fair. So the court was in fact considering this particular petition, this particular habeas corpus, when in December, while the case was going on, Hadiya gets married. And then she comes to court with this man, Shafin Jahan. So that is the first time everyone, including the court, is coming to know about such a person. And then she says that I have married this Muslim man, Shafin Jahan, according to my own will. However, the Kerala High Court felt that there was indiscrepancies in this wedding, and then the wedding was not properly conducted. So that is when 3 months later in March, the High Court annulled Hadiya's wedding. So this was an unprecedented move by the Kerala High Court, which also drew a lot of flak in Kerala and outside. So after this, after their wedding was annulled, naturally Shafin Jahan went to the Supreme Court against this appeal. So that's how this case is now, from a mere habeas corpus petition that Ashokan filed for his daughter, it has now reached a point where Hadiya's case is being termed as a case of love jihad. It has also grabbed national and international headlines. So after this case, also after this Hadiya's case gained so much importance and so much media coverage, there have been a lot of similar cases that came up in Kerala. So at least three or four cases where came to the court where parents of Hindu women who converted to Islam or Christianity to marry a person of their choice, they have gone to the court alleging that the man who married their daughter has ISIS links. So in the last two years we have seen a lot of such cases where parents of the women have gone to court against the wedding. So this is what the case is, has a repercussion in the state per se.
Well, that's it for now from here. We're of course yet to hear from Hadiya herself on these developments that have taken place in court. But remember, it's not over yet. The next hearing for this case will be on February 22nd. We're of course waiting to hear from Hadiya herself. But do stay tuned for more updates from the News Minute.